the world's first mass-produced consumer-level knee exoskeleton, the Dansis Z1. Oh my god! Faster, smoother, more secure. Yes, as fun as it looks, the Z1 uses a motor at the knee joint to deliver power assistance and is designed to offer maximum protection for your knees, whether you're hiking, trekking, or even skiing. Especially when going downhill or downstairs, the pressure on your knees can reach 4 to 7 times your body weight. That's when this device can make a huge difference. Happy knees, happy life. Just ask any elderly person. This thing is super lightweight. I've tested it in all sorts of situations over the past couple of weeks, and here's my honest first-hand experience. As the successor to Dansis's hit product, the X1 exoskeleton, which raised over $1.5 million last year. Yes, all crowdfunding orders have been shipped and received lots of positive feedback, according to official Dansis info. I actually took the X1 to CES 2025, and everyone loved it and want to try it out. So, can the Z1 achieve the same success? In this video, I'll cover everything you need to know, share real-world test results, and compare with the first-gen X1 to help you decide which one suits you best. I even wore both devices at the same time just to experience the ultimate four-leg exoskeleton combo. Make sure to watch till the end. Unboxing! Alright, let me show you what's inside really quick. By the way, this is a prototype, so the final version you receive might be a bit different from what you see now. World's first lightest knee exoskeleton from Dansis. Wow, it's so light. Let me just unfold it, just like that. Wow, that's it. This is how it looks when fully unfolded. Also, we have a support pad here. And don't forget the belt. Let me show you how to wear it. As you can see, the two blade connectors sit side by side, evenly spaced about 2 to 3 centimeters away from the pad seam. And that's how you wear it. And compared to the belt from the X1, I really like this one great improvement, the quick release buckle. You can always put on or take off. And of course, you can always adjust the length of your belt according to your waist. And now let's wear the Z1. Wow, just cannot wait. First, we have to insert this support pad. As you can see, there's a scale here, which I will show you a little bit later. First, let's just put to this slot. This button here, just press. Super smooth, isn't it? And release the button to fix the support pad. Now, let's connect the Z1 to your belt. Put it on your thigh, hook it on. The belt for the lower leg. I really like this Velcro design, which you can always adjust to fit your size. And check this out, the belt here is also adjustable. So even if you have longer legs or you are super tall, don't worry about it, it still fits you. And just as Dansis told me, this design is not the final version. They may have, you know, easier ways to replace this, but now it is just what it is. If you feel this support pad a little bit away from your thigh, you can always adjust it. Make sure to attach to your thigh. And that's it, that's how you wear it. Actually, you can just use it for one leg. But first, let's connect to the power. The same for the other leg. That's it, let's power the thing on and see how it works. Press and hold the button to turn it on. You will hear a beep and then double press to activate it. Oh my god! Once you activate it, you can feel the instant power, the two forces that apply to the support pad and also the lower leg part. I can feel the power. Oh my god, this is too far! Okay. I can like sit here like for hours. Whoa! I think I can jump even higher. Okay, let's just walk a little bit. And now we have this almost 90 degree vertical slope. Let me just, okay, climb it. Wow, as you can see, when I was just about to fall, it's like There are two hands that literally push your lower leg and your thigh, like push. Don't fall off, climb quick. Oh my God, unbelievable! That makes climbing so much easier. All right, and even more about the motor, actually the same from the X1. It weighs 300 grams and it can basically lift 3.35 kilograms of weight. And if you're curious about the noise, here you go. And that's the noise, quiet, right? And now let me try to explain why this thing gives you your knees like much relief, okay? I'm trying to crush like this two axis. As you can see, like how much power this pad applies to your calf. Come on, do you see how much depth, right? How much depth it applies? When you walk, you will just move forward, right? And then this pad is just like a giant hand to push it forward. And the same applies to this pad. And that's why you need this support. So the support provided by the two leg pads significantly distributes the force that would otherwise be absorbed by the knees. That's why when you clamp, you will feel much easier. Wow. But how about when you go down here? So you might think, oh, it might be too dangerous because it has these two forces to push you forward, right? But actually, no, let me just show you. When you go down here, the rear pad will give you a lot of support. So basically it's like you're sitting on a bench and then you can go like steady and then your knee joint will get much less pressure. Well, that how it works. And I think I can still walk another 20 miles. Now, here's the test. We see there's a super long, steep slope. And I'd like to walk with and without the Z1 to see who has the best results, who are the better results. I will use Apple Watch to record everything, to check out the data like average speed, heart rate, calories burn situation. Ready? 3, 2, 1, let's go. Oh my God. I think my cameraman just cannot keep up with me. So now this is so fun. That's it. Now let me stop it. We see total time, total distance, average pace, average heart rate, 180 BPM. All right, and that's the data. Now, let me get rid of this Z1 and walk the same route without wearing it. Ready? 1, 2, 3, 2, 1, let's go. Okay, go. You just stay here, right? Okay, let's go. Let's just stop here. Okay, 2 points. Let's compare the data. There's two we just tested. One is like the one without. Okay, it takes 2 minutes and 48 seconds, which is like 20 seconds more. The distance is about the same, and 80 consumes more calories. And heart rate speed is one more. And now we, so you see, take less time, faster, you know, faster average pace is faster. Total calories consumed is less. Yeah, that's the data. I think it's quite objective. And also, as you can see, when I go up here without the Z1, I almost slipped once, oh right? Yeah, I can tell you it's more secure when you're wearing the Z1. And those are my real world test results with the Z1. What a surprise. So the $1 million question is, which one should you choose? The Dynasys Z1 knee exoskeleton or the X1 hip exoskeleton? I think it really depends on your specific needs. The Dynasys Z1 is ideal if you are dealing with knee pain, fatigue, or pressure, especially when going downhill, climbing steep slopes, navigating stairs in daily life, doing tasks that require crouching, or engaging in high impact activities like jumping. It provides powerful support directly to the knee joint, helping reduce strain and prevent injury. Perfect for hiking, skiing, warehouse workers, electricians, or anyone who frequently squats or kneels on the job. On the other hand, the X1 is a hip exoskeleton. It uses two motors and hips to assist your thighs, making walking feel lighter, longer, and faster. It's perfect for long distance hiking, running, or other endurance scenarios. To put it simply, if you enjoy skiing, hiking, or other activities that put a lot of pressure on your knees, And I want to protect your knees early on, get support when walking downstairs, or sitting and standing up, or reduce impact during heavy-duty tasks, go with the Z1. If you're looking for more horizontal support to work or run faster and with less effort on flat terrain, then the X1 is your best bet. Choosing the right exoskeleton will completely change your experience. Just out of curiosity, I tried wearing X1 and Z1 at the same time. And no, it looks pretty wild. And trust me, the experience is just as intense. Each joint can be used independently or work in sync. And when they do, the coordination is incredible. It honestly makes you feel like Superman. I mean, every part you need to run faster and with less effort has a motor helping you. Now, my conclusion. The Dynasys Z1 is truly one of the most innovative products I've tested recently. As the world's first knee assist exoskeleton, I can only imagine how challenging it was to develop, especially syncing power assistance with the user's natural walking rhythm. Everyone walks differently, so creating an algorithm that recognizes and adapts to individual gait patterns is no small task. And yet once again, Dynasys has impressed me. Whether I'm jumping, walking, while running, the Z1 delivers a smooth and responsive experience that feels completely natural and effortless. To me, this device is perfect for people who frequently hike, climb hills, or enjoy other outdoor activities. And it's great for everyday home use too. It significantly reduces knee strain and fatigue, helping relieve pain and protect your joints. If you're active or simply want to prevent long-term knee damage, the Dynasys Z1 is definitely worth checking out. And if you're interested in this product, please check the link in the description. I'm back now on Kickstarter. Thanks for watching. I'm Sammy. I'll see you on the next mountain. Bye-bye.